It is a post UFC 135 wrap up. All the dogs wanted to be a part of the show, so they're all part of the show. Holy John Jones. Now, I think it is Paul Cicchini on our Facebook page that posted that he thought that Rampage would have taken it if it went to the fifth round. I'm pretty sure he's addicted to drugs and we have sought help for him. John Jones, however, and Rampage, what a absolute stunning performance on the part of John Jones. Four rounds, ends up tapping him, rear naked choke. I think that's mostly because John Jones ran out of moves. He had tried every other move that he had and he thought, what the hell? We tried a flying triangle. We tried a, every sort of kick and punch under the sun, save for the ones that Steven Seagal hasn't taught me yet. Let's try a rear naked choke. He walks away with a victory. The other things that we've learned at UFC 135, number one, if a heavyweight isn't named Junior Dos Santos or Cain Velasquez, they belong on the undercard. Travis Brown and Rob Broughton was terrible, and I thought it couldn't get any worse until Mark Hunt and Ben Rothwell stepped in. Did those guys have any idea what they were doing? I mean, who thought that Mark Hunt, A, was going to win, and B, look in better shape? Seriously, whatever. And Nate Diaz against Gomi, what a way to kick that card off. Diaz looked absolutely amazing, which is great, because at 170, he looked absolutely terrible. So at 155, I'd love to see him stay there for a little bit longer. Matt Hughes, hoping that he's done, because he looked good for about a minute, and Josh Koscheck turned it on and ended the night. The other note, Ski Town native Tony Ferguson proved that he might actually have something in the UFC. What a great performance. Breaking the jaw of Aaron Riley, and great call by his corner, calling the fight, as opposed to putting Aaron back out there in the second round. All in all, a spectacular night. We've got some great events coming up, and my hope is, I know they didn't say anything in the press conference, my hope is UFC December 30th, put Rashad and Jones on that card. Overeem and Brock, Rashad and Jones, the night before New Year's Eve. Sign my ass up. Catch us this Friday. We wrap it up in a little bit more detail, and hopefully Paul Cicchini is out of rehab and ready to pay attention to the fights this time. Take care.